What's up, guys? So yesterday I stopped by the Chrome Stop and I bought this chrome sleeve, the chrome top, and this chrome cover. So I'll be switching that out. I also bought new airline so I can have just straight airline running all the way down, and I don't have these showing up here. And let me show you what I got. So here's the airline. It already comes with the sleeve, so you got both airlines in here. Here is the gear shift sleeve to cover. This one was $10. Here is the cover. This one was $6.99. The chrome cover. And then this is the shifter piece. This one was $59.99. So here it is. So I'll be installing all of this today. Let's get to it. Alright, so the first thing I have to do is remove the sleeve cover. So now that this one's removed, I can go ahead and take the hoses out. All you gotta do is push this little tab in and they'll slide right out. Same thing on the other side. So now I can remove this shifter knob right here. So all you gotta do is loosen the nut and this piece will come right off. Now about the airlines on this one, you don't really have to worry because it tells you right here goes the red airline and right here it says black. So now I have to remove this cover right here, and you do that with a flathead screwdriver. So there it is. This is the top part you got to remove, and then there's two screws in there you got to take off. So I'll go ahead and remove those two right now. So here's one of them. They're pretty long screws. And the other one's still in here. And here's the second one. So here's my new chrome knob. And here are the holes for the screws. One there and one in the front. And that's it. You just tighten them up. They don't have to be too tight, just pretty snug. And there it is. So now I can get my chrome cover. So I can even use this one if I wanted to. Put it in here. But I think the chrome one would look nice. So here it is. And you just snap this one in here. So here it is. I think I dented the top a little bit up here when I was hitting it. But the shifter knob is ready to go. And now I can put it back on the extension. Looks pretty good, other than the two dents I made. But the little cover is like $6, so I could just buy another one. But I think I might just put this one back on later on. I kind of like how it looks. What do y'all think? Yeah, I think I might use this one again. But here it is. And before I put it back on, I have to remove my sleep first. And put in the chrome one in there. So here's the chrome sleeve. And this one goes this way. So just make sure that you put this one in there before you put the shifter. And this is how it would look. So now I can tighten this knob up. Gotta make sure it's straight the way I want it. Seems to be straight right here. So that should be tight enough. Now before I do anything else, I will remove my quick connects. So here are my quick connects. I will remove these. And now, after I've done that, I can send my old airlines all the way down, because I'll be using new airlines, so I won't be needing those. And there's a hole right there. So now that that's done, I'll grab my new airline. I will run it first through my sleeve. And then the other end, put it in through that hole. Push it down there the most I can. Before anything else, now I have to open these up and connect them to my shifter. All right, so I just cut it, the sleeve to my airlines. Here they are, the red and the black. So now I have to connect them to the shifter. First one I'll connect is my black airline. It's this one right here. And my red one's on this side. Make sure they're all the way in there. Okay. Now I can cut these ends off. Now that that's done, I can put the rest, all of this extra, all the extra airline I have all the way down. So let's go ahead and do that right now. So there it is. Now I got all that extra airline down there. I can bring up my sleeve. So now I will put my sleeve on the shifter. And I can go ahead and screw those on. Now these two screws, they don't have to go that tight. Just snug. That's it. So we're done up here with the shifter. And it's perfectly straight. So now we gotta go under the truck. And there's also the range selector here. They sell a cover for it, a little chrome cover. So I'll be ordering that one online. Here, I'm gonna show you. It's only like $5. I found it on eBay too. eBay has it for $4.50. So here it is. That's the little cover for the range selector. You can see it right there. So I'll be ordering that one soon. The airlines go right here. Red and black. So here's what I'm gonna do. This is the new airlines coming from the top, and this is the old one that's hooked up to the transmission right now. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut the old one right here and out of the quick connects, and that'll be a way easier process. Okay, here's the old airlines. I'll just have to open it up like I did with the top. All right. So here's one end, and I just gotta get the second one ready. This is the one that's coming from the shifter. Now I can cut it off. Have both ends ready to connect. So let me take the old quick connects I had up there and reuse those. Red on red. And black on black. So there it is, they are connected now. The transmission airlines are connected. Now all I have to do is turn the truck on and make sure I don't have any air leaks here or on the shifter. All right, so I built up air pressure already. There's no air leaks coming from here. These are leaking, so I have to tighten them up. So I think I found my problem. Not sure if you can see it, but the red line, the red hose, it has a cut right here, look. It has a cut right there, so I think that's where the air is leaking from. So I have to go ahead and make this line shorter. I'm gonna try to hook it up now and hopefully it does not leak. Black line seems to be all right. I didn't see that cut on that hose. I probably did it by accident. All right, let me turn the truck on now and hopefully it doesn't leak again. Yeah, so that was a problem, guys. There's no more air leaks and I will now push the airlines in here and that's it. It's pretty. So I'm gonna try my old cover on it and see how it looks. I think it would look better. So there it is. I'm not gonna lie, I think I like how it looks like this. It looks a little bit more original with a touch of chrome, you know? Man, I actually like how it looks now with this. It's like if it was the original shifter piece with just chrome added to it, plus I dented the chrome piece. These things, they're pretty hard to get in there, so yeah, fuck that one. But this one looks real nice. I actually like how it looks with this one, with the original. It looks real good. Oh, and I gotta put zip ties on my airlines right now to make it look nicer. And if you didn't see my other video, check it out. I painted the shifter itself. We painted that and added these chrome valves. So here are my zip ties. I will do one. Right here towards the top. So right here is perfect. That's the first one. Man, I gotta watch out with this knife. Caterpillar knife, sharp as hell. I'm gonna do my second one right here. I just use four zip ties. So there it is. And I already talked to the chrome stop yesterday. I'm getting a 16 inch steering wheel, which is a little bit smaller than this. This is an 18, the 16 is probably an inch shorter on each side. Chrome with the black outside. So that's kind of going with it.